some of our plants, they usually have different watering schedules. Hey guys, and welcome back to our YouTube channel. I'm Sam, and our topic for today is our watering schedule. So we have different types of watering schedules for different types of plants. The general rule in watering your plants is, water your plants once the topsoil is dry. To do this, stick your finger into the soil 1 to 2 inches from the top. Check if it's dry, or you can use a moisture meter to help you check if the soil is wet or dry. If it's dry, then it's safe to water the plant. Watering your plants will depend on these factors: location of your plant and the type of plant. Location: plants outside your house will usually require more watering than those placed inside your house. Outdoor plants usually get so much light from the sun, which makes them dry out fast compared to the indoor plants. Some plants like more water, while other plants don't like to be wet at all times. Ferns usually love water. You can water them every day, even twice a day, and they will love it. They will not get root rot. In fact, based on our experience, you can actually put ferns in a pot without a hole, and they will grow and grow. Doing this will allow you to skip watering from daily to two times a week or even once a week. Peace lilies and sensation, or giant peace lilies, also like water. They can take everyday watering or skip a day or two, and they would be just fine. If you forgot to water about them, they're really dramatic actors, so they'll get all droopy like this. For your plants like Calatheas, Thromanthes, and Tinanthes, love to be in moist soil but not wet, or else they will get root rot. They do not like to be dried out, or else you will see browning at the edges of their leaves. Like prayer plants, Alocasias, Anthuriums, and Syngoniums also like to be in moist soil. For these plants, we water them twice a week. Monsteras don't like to be overwatered. Philodendrons and Photos like to dry out. These plants are prone to root rot if you water them often. Overwatering them will kill them, so it is safe to water them once a week. Anglonemas are also easy to care, as they can tolerate moist or drying out of soil. Some plants like snake plants and zizi plants can tolerate underwatering, so you can water them once a week or once every 2 weeks. Cacti can survive even when you water them once a month. If you're unsure, always remember that underwatering is better than overwatering. Underwatering will just cause browning of the edges of your plant's leaf, but overwatering will kill them. For easier monitoring, we follow a watering schedule for our plants depending on the type of plant. We usually water every Saturdays and Wednesdays. On Saturdays, we water all our plants.
Today is Wednesday in the Philippines. I'm not sure where you live, but it's Wednesday here. So it's usually our watering schedule for our plants. The materials you need is a watering can, like this one. Fertilizer, like our blackstrap, sugarcane, molasses, and water, preferably rain water because it's really healthy and it's kind of like magic for them. Usually, we would mix our fertilizer with the rain water. So we use our fertilizer, our molasses, because it makes the plants energetic and happy. You will have to pour it enough for a cup, a spoon. Place it until you have a full cup and a spoon. Then place it inside the rainwater and mix. After mixing, you would want to pour it into your watering can. Since it's Wednesday, we're not gonna water these plants, the monsteras, the philodendrons, and the photos, because they might get overwatered. For monsteras, photos, and philodendrons, usually we water them once every week. Except for our Monstera Adansoniae, because based from our experience, it likes getting watered twice a week. So we water it twice a week along with our Calatheas, the prayer plants. So for today, we are gonna water these plants. We are gonna water our Orbifolia, our Calathea Triostar, our Alocasia Black Velvet, and this Anthurium Crystallinum. We're gonna water them today because they like to be watered twice a week and they don't want to be really dry. Learn something new from our video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and leave a comment down below what our next video should be. And if you haven't watched our previous videos, go check them out. Our Monstera Deliciosa care tips and our legit ba ang Monstera Deliciosa stem cutting sa SHOPEE. We'll see you soon. Bye!